Hello, and welcome to a playthrough of Blue Wish Resurrection on Heaven difficulty, which I guess is the lowest difficulty level. So, this is kind of a relatively easy beginner shmup, as they might call it. And, the reason why I picked this one is because, that hurt my brain. And it also has lots of ways to give yourself some leeway. Apologies, I'm just trying to adjust the volume so that it doesn't start screaming at you the moment that it starts up. I don't know why the volume's so loud on this thing, but it's just super, super duper loud. And I can't figure out how to actually turn it off. So, you know what? It's going to stay that loud, and I don't care. So there you go. So I did this yesterday, and I was surprised at myself. So I died 3 times, as it says miss, and obviously I had auto guard on. So this game is kind of like all those other bullet hell, quote-unquote, shmups, but it has a guard, which is basically like, if you have extra bombs, they're basically defend you from blowing up immediately. So it has an interesting contrast between risk and reward. Do you use the bomb to clear the whole screen, or do you try to weave your way a path through the bullets and then, you know, make it through the game? And you also get a score bonus for keeping as many bombs as possible. So it's in your best interest not to get hit. So I would say 22 million is pretty respectable, considering I had no idea what I was doing. But maybe you think differently. And I chose the default ship, because the default ship is the default ship, and I don't know any better. So yeah, there you go. I would recommend this game to anyone, considering it's completely free, and it's actually relatively easy, and it kind of eases you into the whole concept of trying to dodge and weave your way through a massive rain of bullets. So without further ado, let us go into the realm of the bullet hell. All right, it says ZGO because I put in my name wrong. Okay, so I think the scoring system here is based around proximity killing and also around getting lots of blue chips. And there's also a bullet canceling thing going on. Certain enemies on the screen, if you kill them, they cancel all the other bullets on the screen. So it makes it relatively easy to make it through lots of stages. As well, there seems to be like treasure chests everywhere at certain areas on the stage, and if you put your ship around them, they just give you lots and lots of points until they fade off screen. So it's actually not half bad. So as you can see here, there are certain enemies that are shooting directly at you, and there are certain enemies that are shooting wide spreads that have a distinct pattern. So it seems to me that the key to surviving in these games is moving slowly when you know there are bullets that are aimed at you, and then using the rest of the time to dodge and weave the larger bullet spreads. I don't know if there's any particular technique name attached to all these. Probably like, I don't know, bullet, yeah. Well, anyway, you're trying to like streaming the bullets towards particular locations, so it's probably something like that. And we've arrived at the first boss, who is not too difficult. I'm sure there's some scoring tricks around here, but as you can see, there's also a tiny dot on your player character. And when you hold the button down, you get a more focused shot, which allows you also to slow down, like really slow down. And that slowdown allows you to actually weave through these bullet patterns like you wouldn't be able to normally. And I'm pretty sure if you kill bosses when they're at a certain point, or you get them to the next phase when there's enough bullets on screen, you also get point bonuses. So the bullet canceling also applies there. Yeah, see right there, I got hit, and so it took one of my bombs, and the guard is still up, but I lost a bomb, which means I lost a pretty hefty score bonus at the end of the stage. Yeah, but you know, first stage is never really that bad in these kinds of things. So yeah, so you get an item bonus, and you get a bomb bonus, 50,000 points per bomb, which isn't that bad, but alright. As you can see here, I'm trying to go to the front top of the screen, because I know there's going to be like a million billion bullets, and if I do it that early, at least I can direct where the bullets are going to go, to some degree. Yeah, I think a lot of these kinds of games seems to be managing where you are, relative to the rest. Like, I didn't memorize any of this. I just kind of, like, winged it. I went through this game a couple times, and I don't think I beat it any other time other than this. So, and this is on the easiest difficulty level, where I assume the bullets are really, really slow. So I don't think it's going to be much of a problem for people who are experienced in the genre to do, and it's also going to be pretty easy for most people who take just a little bit of time. I mean, because the bullets go so slow, it's really easy. Yeah, and he has a bunch of different parts, which I'm sure bullet cancel for extra points if you're patient enough, but I'm just trying not to die, so I think basically that's how you should approach a lot of these games, is first go, you should try not to die, and then eventually you may be able to figure out, like, scoring tricks to get you extra one-ups, because in this game in particular, I'm pretty sure that every 5 million points gets you an extra life, which you're gonna kind of need. Obviously, I technically died more than 3 times because of the auto-guard system, but I'm not willing to divulge that. Yeah. Yeah, there are a lot of bullets on screen, but yeah, if you know not to move very much in certain points and position yourself right, you won't have much of a problem. Look, right there. See? They all just go harmlessly by you because you were in that one position when you were moving. All right, boss 2. Actually, I must have gotten a really bad score on the first stage because I'm not even at 5 million yet. Alright, usually these crosshatch patterns kind of, like, screw me up. But here, like, a lot of this pattern is just, like, standing still. That one. And then this one is just a little bit of weaving here and there. Yep, I got hit. Yeah, what are you gonna do? I think I might die again on this one. I'm not sure. Yep. Yeah, there's also a difference between trying to thread a bullet pattern, which you shouldn't always do, and sometimes you should just try to avoid the pattern entirely. Like, that one was not very hard. Like, you could dodge and weave like a crazy person, but this one's not even that bad, if you think about it. See, look. That whole boss, I did pretty good on that one. It's sometimes it's memorization, sometimes it's not. And look, there we go. Million point bonus. Excellent. Okay, stage 3. There's 5 stages, if you were curious. So, this should be a relatively short video, I would have to guess. There's so many interesting things to say, though. So, yeah. It picks up a little bit on stage 3, which is kind of normal for these kinds of games. Usually there are, like, 5 stages, and then they have, like, here we go, you know, we're just gonna throw everything at you. Yeah, but, you know, it's going so slow in this game that it lets you, like, observe the patterns before getting totally swamped. Yeah, and that was actually a nice point bonus there. I think I watched a replay and saw that one, so I will admit that I totally cheated. Oh man, so this part gets a little hectic. But as long as you know, like, to put yourself and plant yourself at a particular point in the screen and then move them around slowly, you're usually good. I'm doing a little dumb thing right now by trying to weave, but I'm basically moving back so I can create a path for myself to exit onto the other side. It's actually working pretty well. It's weird. If you play enough of these games, you kind of get a feel for how the patterns are constructed. Because it's more reliant on feel. Like, you can't, like, look at your ship the entire time you play the game, because, like, you won't be able to live. It's only when the patterns are dense enough that, like, your hitbox is threatened, which is, like, super, super small. But you have to know what's coming up, and you also have to see the bullets coming. Because you can't just be, like, walking in blind. Because otherwise you're just going to get hit repeatedly. So there's kind of this weird balance of having the perception to know when to look up and when not to. I don't really like this pattern very much. Especially the... Because it shoots one that you can weave between and then another one that you can't. Oh yeah, this part. Ugh. See, but it only took a little bit of movement there. Whoa, okay, that was a total mistake on my part. I almost killed myself. Yeah, see. I figured I'd get hit. You know, lots of points, though. Yeah, but look how complicated this is, and then see how little I moved in that phase. Now this phase, okay, that's a little more difficult. And there's the slowdown, which, if you hadn't guessed, was completely intentional on the part of the developer, because it'd be incredibly difficult to avoid otherwise, and I got hit because I was acting dumb. Sometimes you just make mistakes and you get hit, and, you know, that's all right. As long as you're learning something, it's fine. I mean, progress is hard to come by in these... Oh, see, I got... Is this three times? Wow, that was really bad. I haven't watched this back since yesterday, so... Hooray! Shield bonus items. Interesting. Okay, stage four... Looks like the usual. Yeah. But there you go. I was actually paying attention, and I made the bullets aim where I wanted them to go. Yeah. I think I get trapped in a few points in this, but I think it's because I wasn't paying attention right. And that's why I basically killed myself. Oh, yeah, see right there? That was bad. This looks worse than it is. I think the bullet canceling makes it a lot easier than it probably would be otherwise. And the big ships have health meters specifically for scoring purposes, so... And also to make it so you don't crap your pants. You see how many bullets coming at you? Yes. Ooh. Oh, man, look at this. Yeah, but look, you can weave through that. Not that bad. Oh, if you're curious, I'm playing this with, let's see, a Street Fighter 4 Tournament Edition joystick for the Xbox 360, which I had to use Joy-to-Key in order to actually get the keyboard movements to map to the actual pad. And that, I just barely avoided getting hit. I'm pretty sure I die mostly on this stage. Yep. Oh, there we go again. And then at this point, I realize I only have one life left, and I say to myself, oh goodness, I better step it up. Yeah, so if you want to play with a joystick, you got to play that way. You know what? A keyboard is perfectly acceptable, I'm pretty sure, because the game is basically defaulted to, like, Z, X, C, which is, yeah, Z, yeah, it's fine. Works fine. You know what? A keyboard and a joystick are both digital movement, so it's relatively similar. I just like the feel of the arcade joystick, and I'm sure it's not for everybody, but as far as accuracy of control goes, you can't go bad with a keyboard. Plus, it's relatively easy to play with a keyboard after a while. I'm sure it is, but I don't know. I'm just an old-school console arcade guy, and I don't really care about that. I'd rather play with, what do you call it? Actually, you know what? I grew up on consoles, so arcades are relatively new to me, but whenever Street Fighter 4 came out, I played a lot with one because they finally had them at reasonable prices, and I actually had an incentive to buy one. So that's what happened. Yeah, so I played a lot of earlier shmup stuff with controllers, and it was weird. I really thought there was a safe spot here, and I totally blew this. I shouldn't have gotten hit. That was just dumb. There you go. Well, what are you gonna do? Yeah, this part gets relatively intense. Yeah, and I got hit again. Yeah, it's mostly on this boss. And now, here, if I get hit, I die. So, that should be fun. Yeah. Just barely. Here we go again. This one, not as bad as I thought it was when I started actually looking at what was happening. And when I'm looking at it right now, especially with the slowdown, it's like, yeah, I know what's happened. I think there might be an option that turns the slowdown off, although I don't understand why you would want to do that. Does it increase your score or something? Probably? I don't know. And there's a lot of mysteries of this game, and I don't actually know why. Why certain things happen as they do, but... Yeah. So, wow. The score must increase substantially on the last stage because I am at 12 million? Oh, wow. Okay. But I did get an extra life, which is probably enough to get through this last stage. Yeah, look at this. Usually last stages are pretty crazy. pretty crazy. Is about right. Whoa! Yep, see, I knew that the big enemies usually bullet cancel, so I was pretty safe there up until the moment when he died. Oh, and then right here I go. Oh, crap. Got hit. Yep, so basically it's a mixture of kind of weaving through bullet patterns, trying to completely avoid bullet patterns, and then knowing which enemies do the bullet cancel, which in this game tend to be the big ones with life meters, almost in every single case. So the game is actually very consistent. And there's only purple and pink as the color of the bullets, which also helps in terms of figuring out what's what, because they contrast completely with the background, which makes it very easy to tell what you're supposed to be doing. Yeah, and this one's also relatively easy. You just tap a little bit and then move around. This looks more complicated than it is, and I got hit anyway, but you know how it is. So yeah, I am thinking about the fact that I have one life left, but at that, you know, if you are getting stressed over that, you just can't let it bother you, because if you do, you'll definitely screw up. I should know from experience. And I got hit right there, right? See? If you get nervous, you just, make mistakes for no reason. So you just gotta, tell yourself, shut up. Shut up, self. I want to beat the game. And then maybe you will. Although I do admit, this game is, super forgiving compared to, Dodonpachi Daioujiro, which I am, really bad at by comparison. And it's supposed to be one of the harder games in the entire genre, so, I'm a bit of a masochist, I guess. I don't know, I just like the music. The music of this game actually is pretty rad. Considering this is a free-to-play game, basically, that some guy made a decade ago. Thank you, some guy. I'm sure there's an official name for you somewhere on some forum, but yeah, this game's pretty rad, so. And I got hit again. Yeah. Also, I didn't have any coffee all day, which was surprising to me, so there's absolutely no caffeine in my system while playing this, and that was a bit weird, but I did fine, so I'm happy with myself. Yeah, and this last stage, wow, goodness. And here's the last boss, who is, not incredibly hard, but hard enough. And I believe this is one of the few points where there's a bunch of slowdown. So, that should be fun. And I was freaking out at this point. I have one life, and I have two bombs. So, functionally speaking, I can get hit twice. Because in this game, having a heart means I think you get a game over if you die. Oh no, I have two. I just got two right before I got here. So, yeah. Those extra points help a lot. I think a lot of games, people are like, oh, whatever, I'm not going to score. But I'm finding, playing a lot of these games, just barely did I get that one off. Playing a lot of these games, I found that actually playing for score is incredibly useful because you kind of need extra lives to win, especially if you don't know the game that well. So you actually do have to score. Some of the extends seem kind of incredibly insane. They call them extends usually, which is just extra lives, but they seem insane until you try to figure out how the scoring mechanics work, and then it becomes a little bit easier to actually play the game. And plus, you're playing for score and for survival at the same time, which is, you know, both and are fun. Wow, and here we are. We're almost at the end. And this pattern looks, yeah. I don't know, this boss is not as hard as I thought it would be. Once I got here and it was, focused, and I said, I'm just gonna beat this, I was just like, oh, okay. Because all that's really happening is that there's a bunch of crap on screen, and then they're shooting, single bullets at you. And the single bullets are actually really easy to avoid if you're paying attention any noticeable respect. So, here we go. I'm super happy with myself, because I did not expect I would beat a game like this so early, even if it's kind of an easy one. And, so there you go. That is Blue Wish Resurrection Plus, which is available for free, and I guess I will have to include a download link below, but you could probably just Google it and get a copy of it. I believe that the download going around now has the stuff unlocked, which was not unlocked originally, so if you're looking for those things, which are mostly extra ships and stuff, you could probably find that download pretty easily. And, yeah, I would say, because it's free, you should at least give it a try. You know what? If I could beat it, and I'm really bad at these games, I would say, then anybody can. And it's a lot of fun, and it's like 20 minutes of just pure focus, which is approximately the length of this video. And I hope this was interesting, and I'll do more of them if I happen to actually complete any of these games, or maybe I'll do kind of a work in progress sort of thing. Yeah, of course, I'm also playing Metal Gear Solid 5 at the same time, which is going to make it more interesting. But anyway, I will see you guys next time.